How you doing, LT? Let me turn my
me.
Phone around. How you doing, LT?
How you doing, me? Good to see you, man.
Nice to see you too, man. Nice to finally meet you too. I heard a lot about you and everything you was pushing for with the bills that got passed. So I wanted to do this on Instagram Live because, you know, in our social media world, we don't really get an understanding of like who's pushing for us and who is the guy, who are the people that actually signing things and making things go through to better the system. So if you could start it off and just tell the people about Michigan and the Bills in a short way, we'd love to hear it.
Yeah, first of all, man, I really appreciate you for using your platform like this and really being a leader on criminal justice. You know, your story is a lot of people's story, people for the system is done wrong and done unfairly. And so my job, I'm the lieutenant governor of the state of Michigan, y'all. And my job really is to make sure that we can pass laws that actually help people and give people a chance of success. And even if something happened or if somebody made a mistake, it's our responsibility to give people a path to get back to being their best self. And the criminal justice system has not been designed to do that, especially for Black people, especially for people who grew up poor, who are still fighting with poverty. And so, you know, what we tried to do, me and Governor Gretchen Whitmer, we started when we came into office in 2019, wanted to change our justice system, making it so that, you know, the police could not unlawfully take your things when you get arrested, to doing this work that we just signed into law with reforming the parole system to make sure that, and probation system, because, you know, that's also been kind of a shackle around people's feet, even if they're not currently locked up. And so we went to reform the jail system. We passed a lot of reforms to make it so police can't arrest you for a lot of different things, not that they used to be able to arrest you for. So you never go to jail in the first place. Instead, you can be out working, feeding your family, supporting your community.
Yeah. So if I could tell my story, LT, you know, I'm from Philadelphia, 400 or 500 murders a year. My dad got killed in South Philadelphia. So, you know, at the age of 18, like just the way I live from seeing murder on a daily basis, knowing my dad got killed in the neighborhood, I always just knew in my mind I needed to carry a firearm to protect myself because that was actually necessary. My hood was like Friday the 13th every night, and that was just, that was the environment. So that's the things, the measures I had to take to survive in those areas. So I got arrested, and when I got arrested, when I got to the police station, I had about 30 charges. And, you know, I didn't know what the charges was. I was an 18-year-old kid. I went in front of a bail judge. He basically judged me as if I already committed the crime. He basically said, oh, you pointed a gun at a Philadelphia police officer, your bail $250,000. So when he said that, I tried to speak back. And they told me I could not speak back the cop that was in the room because I was trying to tell him, like, I ain't pointing a gun at the cop. So, you know, that led to me doing time in prison and getting sentenced to 11 and a half to 23 months, I think 11 years probation. So through my 11 years of probation, I want to tell you, LT, I'm from Philadelphia, like where it's kind of hard to even be an angel if you come from my background. So, you know, I never danced on the law. I never broke laws, especially as an adult from 18 years on out. I've been living like a straightforward life. And through my life, of just dancing on the line, because I am young and Black and I'm not perfect, but dancing on the line of not committing crime, they sent me back to prison 3 or 4 times without actually breaking a law, without actually doing anything that could disrupt society. And you know me, I value myself so low at the time. I always grew up in the system since the age of 18. I always thought that was normal, but when I was in prison, sometimes I just couldn't sit with the fact that I was sitting with people that actually did crimes and people who didn't do crimes, you know, like the technical violators, and I was a technical violator most times. You know, me, I would tell you, me, I'm a monster. Like I try to make it through anything. I'm from North Philly, been in South Philly my whole life. I never really looked for sympathy. I just knew I had to do what I had to do, and I never thought we'd have a day like this where I could actually talk to people who are in power, officials who actually are thorough people with character. And, you know, that technical violation thing the judge was doing with me brought me back to prison 3 or 4 times. And me, I had a different background through a different backing through coming to celebrity and the people that I know and my, what would I say, my resources. So it was a little different for me, and I actually had lawyer money to actually back me up. But I always thought about the young guys and the young brothers that come up like me who don't have those things. So When I seen people come out in Philadelphia and stand up for me and march for me, that just made me know I needed to dedicate a piece of my life to helping people get back and not go through what I went through. Like a lot of people say, they only hear us talking about people getting out of prison, but we talking about people who don't belong in prison, people who are trying to rehabilitate their lives and move on to that next stage of their life if they did commit a crime. And, you know, once I got out, I linked with Michael Rubin, Jay, the Reform Group, everybody, Jessica Jackson. And, you know, the support was unbelievable how they were supporting me. So, you know, I wanted to put that on the ground and really make sure that worked for the people, our people, actually. You know, black and brown people go to jail at an alarming rate. Most prisons I've been at, 25% of the prisons were just technical violations. People who smoke weed, people using drugs, addicted to drugs. And, you know, I just always knew that wasn't right. So being here today, LT, I'm just glad that I could get this opportunity to be a part of it. I don't care if I was the one that had to be to go through some little rough shit to help thousands or millions of others. Just knowing that we don't have caps, that now we'll have caps on probation where people can't just take your freedom at the drop of a button. I call it what I always called it. I called it death by paper. Yeah. Because we always talk about, like, if one cop kill a black man, I think more about the courtrooms where people get killed on paper on a daily basis. And I just always kept that in the back of my mind. And the situation landed in my lap, I think it's God that put it in my lap, and I'm just going to own it. I always tell people I'm a remain a rapper. I'm a remain Meek Mill. I ain't going to be breaking the laws, but I'm a own reform. I'm going to make sure the voice spreads as far as it can. If for brothers like you who really put in a lot of work that's in those offices, I make sure I use my platform to push y'all away so we can get this thing, keep it going from state to state and make real change.
No doubt, man. I mean, that's what leadership is all about, man. I just really appreciate you for being willing to tell your story and for really making sure that people know that there is a path and that there are people fighting. There are people like you working in the States all across the country. And, you know, you talk about you from Philly, I'm from the east side of Detroit. Like, I hear you in terms of stuff being really real, you know, where so we come from. And even to make sure, though, that there's a path, and even if people make a mistake, something else we did in Michigan is even if you have something on your record, we made it so that parts of your record can be automatically cleared, you know, after a certain amount of time. So you can have full access to be your best self and live out your dreams. I know you care about getting out our dreams, right? And living out your dreams and being able to be a full person, participate in the economy, you know, do whatever you start a business, whatever you want to do. And that has been something that's been holding people back. And especially something else that we did in this whole bill package, Meek, is, you know, I know when you went to jail, you were in jail for months before you even had a trial.
Yeah.
And in Michigan, more than half of the people who are in jail are there without even having a trial. And that's basically locking people up, separating them from their family. They can't work. They can't provide. And it's just really disrupting your life. And you literally haven't been charged with anything. That is wrong. And so we're trying to end that in Michigan. And I think if we can end it in Michigan, we can end it across the country. And so we're trying to show leadership like that. And I think people like you, the Reform Alliance, are you using your platform, Jay, Van, Jessica, Ruben, the whole crew, really just putting all these resources behind this movement. That's how we're going to make change. The movement can be so big and so strong that nobody can stop it.
Yeah, for sure. So LT, you can let the governor know we appreciate it. I appreciate you, everything y'all did. I believe that this will help many young men and women around the Michigan state, around the Michigan area, and help them better themselves if they actually did ever make a mistake in their lives. Because, you know, in the Bible, in every book you can think of that was made about religion, they always talk about chances. And, you know, now we all humans, I think life is based on chances. My mom always gave me a chance to become who I am now. So, you know, that's what I believe in. It's always good. I want to do this on my Instagram to show face for people like you and give people like you the credit that you deserve so people can actually know who the people are pushing for them. Because me, before I got in this world, I did not know anything about the system, who was pushing for me or who was against me. So, you know, my platform is always available for people like you. And I just want to say thank you for y'all for passing the bills.
Well, much respect, man. I appreciate that. I know I got this shirt that said everybody versus injustice.
Yeah.
I think that's really what this is all about, right? We have to make sure we step up and stand tall for the people who, you know, like you said, you may not have a voice, have a platform. You might feel like you're alone when you're being sort of pressed down by the system, but we need to let everybody know they're not alone, that we can help, that we can hear, we can provide a path out. So that's what it's about, man. So thank you for being you, man, for real. I appreciate you.
Before you go, like, that's the biggest sense of hopelessness for kids in the ghetto when they get caught in the system. they think it's not helping. They think their lives are doomed forever. So, you know, when you think your life is doomed, you don't value yourself to a higher level. So, you know, if they know they got help out there, I think it'd be like kind of a little bit better. We'll be working towards change and not just locking everybody up, throwing them in these little cells.
That's right. That's right. That's right, man.
LT.
Appreciate you too, brother. Take care. Be safe.
All right. Thank you, man.
No doubt. All right.